The Bayou's Grace Food Pantry in Sutherland Spring, Texas is truly unique. Unique not only in that it distributes food and the love of Jesus in a very special way, but it literally has risen from what one might say the ashes, where the director of that food program, Lula White, was tragically gunned down with 25 other people on November the 5th. I was there just 10 days after and saw it immediately had risen up under the direction of Rod and Judy Green and the love that flowed through the people. And as I went back and revisited, I continued to see that love flow as I interacted with Michelle Shields, the daughter of Lula White, the woman that founded the program before. She reflected on her mother and her life. And as she reflected on that, my heart was deeply touched. Now, here were people infused with the love of God that refused to give up in spite of the circumstances. Let's go to Michelle at this particular time.
My mom used to be up here every Friday, and she was a blessing to be here. She was the director, and she would sit at the front desk and greet people. She would check them off the list and always had a smile on her face. So this lady here can attest to that. She was a blessing.
But this one's doing a pretty good job.
Yes, she is. But she took care of people in need. And yes, she was. My mom's name was Lula White. She was my mother. She wanted to be involved to be able to help people. She always wanted to reach out and give a helping hand and to be there when they needed her. Not even just to give them things, but she wanted to be there emotionally for them. She spoke to them whenever they needed someone to talk to. She gave them the guidance if they asked for guidance, and she would try to lead them to God. There wasn't a person that she didn't like. She loved everybody here. So I don't think she didn't not have a friend.
She did not judge one of us.
She just loved us.
That's right here. That's you. I love you.
Well, I love you too.
I mean, that's
so, yeah.
She didn't judge any of us.
Nope, she didn't judge anybody.
She was down at her nose at any of us?
Nope. Well, that's what God, He doesn't want us to do that. And she followed God's rules, His law. Only He can judge. So the pastor and his wife both had to be out of town that weekend in two different states. And she offered to help take care of Annabelle, their 14-year-old daughter. And she was very loving. She was like a grandma to Annabelle. And she called her grandma. And so she went and picked her up from school. Stayed over at her house and then knew that she had to be at church. Both of them came to her house and spent the night, and that morning they caught up and came to church, and she was watching over Annabelle. And I know Annabelle loved being with my mom, her grandma, and I love Annabelle too. She was like a niece to me, and she always protected people that she could as much as she could, and did what God wanted her to do as well. So she just always, anybody needed somebody, any children, people, anybody, she was there. She would try to be close hand for people.
So Lula and Annabelle went to heaven at the same time?
Yes, they did. They both ascended to heaven, the right hand of God at the same time. And I know they were held in hands. So it's a very warm feeling on that. Good morning. How are you?
Good. Thank you.
Good. You get four peppers.
Thank you.
I don't know. You're welcome. There's a red one there. I don't know if that's a... So, and don't forget your five waters. They're over by the door, okay? You're welcome. There's candy there, too. So... I like to see people who actually do care about my mom too. So being here and seeing them give their love that they felt for her, it's a good feeling.
Judy,
You and your husband, Rod, were miraculously saved. You arrived at church late that day.
Yes.
If you had not, you very likely would have a chair sitting there for you and him, wouldn't you?
We would be there. There would be a chair for Rod and myself.
Because Rod probably would have tried stopping that guy, since he carries.
Yes.
And the guy was wearing armor and probably would have shot you next to him, too.
Yes.
You're here for a purpose. You and your husband, Rod, run by His Grace Food Pantry here in Sutherland Springs, Texas.
Yes.
Sutherland Springs, Texas. What does Thanksgiving mean to you this year? How is it different? What kind of reflection after all that's happened the past couple of weeks?
Of all the times for it to happen, it was so very sad for myself, and more than likely I will feel grief and heartbreak, as well as thank you, dear Lord, for keeping us here. I do feel that we have a mission, our mission to serve our community, as well as to serve Him in His honor. All of the younger generations, I'm praying that they will understand this and not let it deter them from going to church and learning that we do have our Father and that watches over us, because He certainly watched over myself and my husband for us to complete our mission here.
In the midst of all the trials and the tribulations, this has been very stressful for you. How can you continue reminding yourself that you're too blessed to be stressed in this way? It's a constant challenge day and night.
It is a challenge. And I believe at this point now, so many days past, I'm starting to get excited to see what He's going to do with my life and where He's placing me, and what more then can I do, not only to help our community, to help each other, to help all the families, to help the community, help anybody I come in contact with.
So you're thanking God in the midst of all this.
I am thanking the Lord.
And can you imagine trying to face all this without Jesus?
No, I can't.
That can have not received
I cannot. There's no way. I have loved ones that are there with Him, and they blessed me to bring me up, and my way of thanking is their way of thanking, and their way of thanking was also in the Lord's. They were brought up in the receiving blessings, and I am receiving blessings through all this sadness, and my heart aches. And with saying that, I am still blessed.
Blessed to have known Lou White, who started this whole work, who'd be sitting at this very place, who's now sitting in the presence of God. Blessed to have known her and all the other people in the church, because you were a member of the church. These were your family.
They were my family. I've been going here for 15 years, and I've seen many families that have had children, and some are not here with us at this time. They've been deceased. Some are here. It's just, I can think of one and think, oh, how much I'm going to miss them. And then all of a sudden it's the other one, and then the next one, and the next one. So it's just a circle of all of our love going out to all the families that have lost their loved ones as well. I mean, they're hurting. It's not just myself.
It's actually too painful even for you to go into that church right now, isn't it?
I cannot go into the church right now. I look from the outside at a distance, and that's as far as I could get.
Well, you and by His Grace Food Pantry here in Sutherland Springs, Texas, will continue to remain in our prayers that God's going to grant you the strength and the courage to continue on. And you've taught us all how we can thank God in each and every situation, and thank Him for life and the opportunities He gives us to serve Him right now.
I do. I appreciate that. I need the strength, and I'm receiving the strength from all of the prayers. There's people all around throughout the United States, and probably internationally too, that have heard about the news. And one man on Sunday had just come in from China, and he came up to me and he said, God bless you, and I'm praying for you to have strength. He said, I just got in from China, and he said, I am so very sorry.
Wow.
Yeah.
The little one we hear back here, Lou, was so excited when when
yes,
their barn. She
yes,
was so excited when that little one
yes,
came.
Yes, and it's difficult to go at one moment to say, "Oh, I don't know if I can do that," but then in the second breath, I say, "Oh yes, you're going to do that."
I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Thank you for joining us.
My name is Brandy Johnson, and this food bank has fed me since Hurricane Harvey, August 2017, and it means everything to me. I had a rough time after Harvey, and then I was sick, and life happened to me several times, and even now, when I'm on my feet, I still share what I can't use with others that are in more shape than me. This is a labor of love. These people genuinely love God, and they're so happy to be here for us, and they treat us like family. We're just like family. We look forward to Friday mornings when we can be with our family. These people, we've met friends. I've met friends and made friends here. It's a wonderful meeting. Friday mornings are always a good morning.
Tell me about Lula.
Oh, Lula checked us in at the table, and she was so precious. And her memory, every time I come in here, it's hard to look at that table and remember her. But I know where she is now, and she's at the big pantry in heaven. And she's not having to check people in. She's got her reward for her service here to those of us that needed it so badly.
What are you going through right now?
Well, my car was just vandalized. It's totaled. And the culprit suspect has the keys to my house. He cut the power cord to my RV. I've had no heat since Monday morning at 5:30. And the pastor here is going to try to at least get the power reestablished. As it turns out, I find out he was a master electrician once upon a time. And so he's going to get my power restored, and that'll be great. That'll be really great.
Well, why did this man do this?
I fired him last week. He wouldn't do a job the way I wanted it done. He was a hothead. And I guess he got even. This was his revenge. He got even.
What does God mean to you?
Oh, you don't have time for this interview, sir. He is my father, my healer, my provider. He's my everything. I couldn't do this. This world is ugly. It's a hard life. And not just for me, for all of us. We're all having hard times. And I don't know how people do it without God and Christ. I don't know how they do it. Well, they don't. They don't with victory. You know, with the police and the deputies and my friends watching, I had peace in the storm when that vandalism happened. I did not cry. I did not freak out. My 13th commandment is thou shalt not freak out. That's peace in the storm. My faith is much stronger than anything anybody can do to me. That car is stuff, and it's God's car anyway. It's God's car.
By His Grace Food Pantry shows the people love, including them and making them part of a family. As I go and visit there, and it's just been such a blessing each time I have, I hear from the individuals and they express how it has really helped them, not only with food for basic living, but also the encouragement and the faith to continue on in spite of the obstacles. Lula White, the former director, gunned down, along with the pastor's daughter, there in the church on November 5th. So many other lives directly impacted. When I was there at the food pantry interacting with people, a dear lady came in, a grandmother who was in the church that Sunday, who'd been wounded while she was in the church. And she was lying on top of her granddaughter, who had also been wounded. She felt it's just the miraculous provision of God's grace that preserved her and her granddaughter. But she was there with her husband, and he was taken to be with the Lord on that particular Sunday. And yet, this dear saint continues to come back and continues to share the love of God. That's what I've seen over and over. So it's not only impacting the members of the congregation, it's impacting the community at large, those that come to the food bank each week, experiencing the God's love in a powerful way that's transforming Sutherland Springs, Texas, in such a powerful, miraculous way as they individuals continue on in spite of such a great tragedy reaching out through the love of Jesus Christ.
My name is Sylvia, and I come to the food bank almost every Friday because it really helps us out, because we're senior citizens and we're low income, and we eat a lot of sandwiches, so we get a lot of bread. And I'm really grateful that the food bank is here for us. And it's not that far from our house. We're about 10 minutes away up the road. So we come here, and now I got my daughter coming here. And I go pick her up, and we come here. And the sweets come in handy because my kids like sweets. And I'm really thankful and grateful that we're able to come here. And especially since it's so close to the house, and it's a good time too, between 9 and 10. So I'm really grateful and blessed that we're able to come here every Friday to get bread and sweets and canned goods.
Tell me about some of the needs in Sutherland Springs. Are there a lot of needy people here?
Yes, I believe there is. I believe there's a lot of low income. And it's hard. It's hard to be a senior citizen and just get your Social Security check once a month. By the end of the month, you usually have more month than you have money. So it's good to know that you can come here. And sometimes they have meat, too. So that comes really good handy. So we're really grateful, yeah, that they're helping us out. 26 ornaments for the victims of the Sutherland Springs shooting, and they're made from seashells, the clamshell seashell, and I put a little gold ornament at the top, a round ball for the head, and a little crown on the head, and I glue it all together, and then I glue it on a ribbon, because the ribbon are the wings, and for the lady that the Mrs. Holcomb that was pregnant, I did a smaller shell and glued it on the top of hers, so to show that was for her and her baby, yeah. And I gave them to the church, and they gave them out to the families. They gave one each out to each of the families. So, yeah, I was glad I was able to do that. I did it because some of the people I knew, Mrs. Holcomb I knew, she was the one that drove the van to pick up the kids for youth group. And my granddaughter went to the youth group. And she went to the church sometimes, too. And she had come to our house several times. And so we knew her. And we were very upset when we found out that she was a victim. And of course, I knew Miss Lou, who was here from the food pantry. And we were just devastated because all summer long we came, and my granddaughter was pregnant, and she was so excited that she was going to have a baby. And the baby came early. And one day we walked in, and I had my granddaughter behind me, and I said, Grandma Lou, I said, we have a surprise for you. And she said, what? And I stepped aside, and I said, she had the baby. And she said, oh, no. And I said, yeah. I said, he decided to come a month early. And she was so excited. And she said, everybody, we have a new family member. We have a new family member. She says, can Grandma hold him? And we said, sure, Grandma can hold him. And she held him, and she walked him around so everybody could see him. So, and she blessed. She did a blessing and a prayer for him. And we were just devastated. Just devastated when we found out she was a victim. So I decided to ease my heart, and I was going to make an ornament out of a seashell for everybody. And my granddaughter delivered them when she went to the youth group. She gave them to Corey, and he gave them out to the family members. They wanted them, so they got to take them home. So every year they'll have a family member hanging on their tree. They'll know that the seashell is for their family member. So I was glad I got to do that.
Brandy, Sylvia, Sylvia's daughter, so many individuals helped week after week after week. There are so many miracles of God taking place at so many different churches all over and so many wonderful food pantries. How I thank God for his people in need being fed by the generosity of each and every member of the congregation. God is blessed. But again, what I find so unique about this is that they just not give up. They could have just totally shut down after the tragedy had happened and turned inward. But they continued to reach out and support one another. The congregation did, as it continued to reach out in the community. not only through the Friday distribution of food, but also on Thursday night when they had the community suppers, which I had the privilege of attending, and then food they give away after that, along with a Bible study from the pastor. They refused to let a great tragedy where a murderer came in and shot and killed 26 people in the congregation, wounded some 23 other people. Over two-thirds of the congregation directly impacted in that way. But they continued to remain steadfast, reaching out through the love of Christ, impacting and directly helping individuals such as Sylvia's daughter.
I'm grateful that this food pantry's here. It helps out my mom, them being seniors in that. It helps me out, not making as much as I should. So it helps me out with food that I need in the household. They're a great help here. I'm glad they have it, and I'm glad it's once a week. Most of the time, it's only once a month you go. So I'm able to get what I need for the week, and that's what it helps out with. And a lot of people are grateful to have this food pantry here. We're just so grateful that they're here to help us out. Sutherland Springs is a great church to come to. They have a great youth group. They helped out a lot at Christmas time. They did the Santa Claus for my kids with gifts and stuff for them. And I was really grateful for that, not knowing how we were going to, you know, supply for them. They helped out with that also. And I was grateful that they were able to do that. They've helped out with my daughter and her brand new baby. When they get stuff in, they ask her, do you need baby food? Do you need this? Do you need that? We've got it in, you know, you can have it. And I'm really grateful for that, that they are able to do that for people here and that they're able to be here once a week to help people out.
Before I go back to Michelle Shields one more time, and she shares the impact that her mother's life, Lula White, had on this food pantry, I need to tell you a little about Michelle and her husband, Ben. Two wonderful, dynamic people, a fantastic testimony that I had the privilege to sit and have them share that testimony on how all this came into being. How did this murder take place? It was a result of a revenge killing where the son-in-law, Michelle, was coming back to kill on that Sunday morning, Michelle and her family. Michelle and Ben are in church every Sunday. For some reason, they weren't there that Sunday. But her mother was there. Her mother was killed, along with the other people in the congregation. But how does Michelle recover from this? By taking it to Jesus. Dynamic testimony. She continues to praise God. She even talks about how she prays for the family, the father, the mother of this man that did this terrible act. She sees that she's alive because of God's grace, because God raised up a neighbor who let out a loud howl and coming out of his house with a gun as the murderer was in there, killing systematically individuals in the church. The murderer comes out and they interact. And some that have heard Steve's story say, well, why didn't he just let him run off? Why did he get engaged in a gunfire with him? What they don't understand is that this man was going to leave the church and go over to Michelle's house and complete what he considered the job of killing them because of Steve's courageous stand. That did not take place. Their lives were spared. And now they're dedicating those lives to serving Jesus, coming and helping at the food pantry with their mother, lifting up the name of Jesus, testifying on every opportunity they have. Yes, my life is truly impacted as I get to know these individuals and interact with them. And so is the lives of those who visit that food pantry every Friday morning. They take away more than just food. They take away the love of Jesus Christ. They show that he is the same yesterday, today, and forever. They have living witnesses that have interacted in their midst and in their community, showing that they're more than conquerors through Christ Jesus who strengthens them. And no matter what the devil might have thrown at them, they continue to testify to the glory of God. And as a result, the numbers are doubling in the church. More people are coming to church than had ever come to before. They're having an opportunity to share God's word everywhere. Because of Christ at work in their lives. Let's go back to Michelle.
My name's Michelle Shields. My mother was Lula White. She was one of the victims in the shooting in Sutherland Springs. And I would just like to say to all the victims' families, you are all my friends, that I love them very much, and that If I could have been the only one, I would have given my life up any day to save their family. But it wasn't my decision. That was God's decision. When the devil takes over, God steps back sometimes because he has other things in plan for everyone else. But I just want to say that I love each and every one of you, and that my heart goes out to each of you. My mom, even before she was a Christian, she knew God. She grew up knowing about our God, but she just never fully gave her life to Him until later in life. But growing up as a child, we grew up at a bowling center, and she managed the lanes and of all the youth. And there wasn't a child that she didn't love or didn't want to help. And we grew close with all of them. And she would take them in and even try to say that they're her adopted children. And when somebody lost a family member or a loved one, some of them stayed with us for months on end until they got situated with their families. She would just give them all the love that she could give them. And I had to share that love, but I didn't mind because I loved them also as brother and sisters. And they always had a helping hand with everybody. If somebody needed a warm meal, she was there to give them a warm meal. If somebody needed a coat, she went and got them a coat. She always was there for somebody. Even growing up, it was nice to grow up with that loving family. My dad, he always was like, okay, who's going to be here tonight for dinner, or who's going to be joining us, or who's going to be staying with us, and what room should I get ready? He was always there to help her too, and both of them had a good understanding of life and what God expected of them. So,
has anyone that was in church that day kind of explained to you what happened, what your mom was doing, or anything?
I've got two different versions. People see things differently when they're in there, and so they did explain to me, but I know that she didn't suffer. And she and a lot of people who said that they got shot said they didn't feel anything until later. So it's like a numbness in your body, a fear of what's going on, which I'm happy to hear that, because I always pray that the pain that they felt didn't last long. So, but they did say that two different people say that she did go quickly.
The By His Grace Food Pantry was actually founded by Pastor Frank Pomeroy's mother. And then after that, Lula White took over, the lady that was tragically killed on November the 5th. Now Judy and Rod continue to carry it forward as they're assisted by Michelle and others. An opportunity to continue to reach out in the community, giving each and every one of us a powerful message. Let's not give God our excuses. Let's give Him our life. This church had every reason to cease many of its programs, but it hasn't. It's only expanded them. I'll continue to lift up the name of Jesus Christ in such a powerful way, dictating to each and every one of us that we can't just be hearers of the word. We've got to be doers also, more than conquerors through Christ who strengthens us. It wasn't easy for them to continue to carry on, but by carrying on, they've continued to reach out, let the light and love of God flow through them, that their witnesses become more powerful, more dynamic, and has much more of an impact than ever before. Not only to Sutherland Springs, Texas, but to the surrounding communities, and yes, in many cases, to the uttermost parts of the earth. God is at work. And the challenge to each and every one of us is, instead of giving God our petty excuses as to why we can't do His work, let's put our hand to the plow and stop looking back. Let's continue to remain steadfast, immovable, abounding in the work of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And as we continue to abound in spite of the obstacles, we will clearly be saying that Christ is risen, and because of His resurrection power, we can indeed do all things through Christ who strengthens us. We have that challenge before us. Let's move forth through the grace and power of our resurrected Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.